Hi all, it's Juha from Ellie. Today I'm going to tell you about a new feature, something that a lot of our clients have been interested in. It's called customizable entity types. So what are these entity types? Here we can see a conceptual data model, and you see that the color codes here are the default types. We have the black, which is for the master data type, the pink is for the contract type, the blue is for the transaction, etc., etc. So by right clicking here, I can see that the entity type is contract and so on. So these are the default types, and these are pretty good for many use cases, but now we want to create our own. So on the main page, if you are an Ellie admin, you'll see the cogwheel menu. This is the admin settings menu. And here we have the settings submenu where you can find the entity type list. Now, these are the default types, but here we can edit them. So we can rename these types, we can change the colors, we can set entity types as defaults, we can delete them and add new ones and so on and so forth. What I'm going to do here is I'll make some changes here and there and we'll see how the model is affected. So first of all, I'm going to make the master type as my default, call that default, and I'll actually make it green. I will delete the existing not set type, and now notice that if I'm deleting an entity type, all the entities that have been assigned to that type will be automatically assigned to the default type when I save the setting change. So we're deleting that, we're deleting the contract type, transactions will be called events from now on, reference we will call objects, that can be gray, and I will delete the transaction detail, away it goes. This is going to be called people, it's going to be orange, and we'll add a new type here called places, which is going to be, well, pink is good for that. So I'm saving these changes, and again, this is something that affects your own Ellie organization as a whole. So all the models, all the entities, for all the users in your Ellie account, these changes will take place now. There we go, we have now new entity types, and now we'll go back to the model and see what it looks like. So here you'll see that first of all, the entities that used to be black in the master type are now green, as I defined that as the color of our default type, and the entity type is called default. The delivery is blue, but it's called event, and the sales contract, which was pink and in the contract type, has now gone back to the default type because I deleted the contract type. So I'm going to make that an event. The product is going to be an object, and the customer type is going to be the default type. And then we could perhaps mark these as people because these have to do with people. So I'm making all these nice orange. And this is how we assign now the new entity types. This is of course a place. And you can see that all the entity types have now been applied. And this is something that you can do for all your models, for all your entities. Of course, also directly via the glossary import and export functionality if you want to do that en masse. So that's how you customize your entity categories in Ellie. You can go to your Ellie account right now and make some changes there, have your own types in there. And if you don't have an Ellie account, go to Ellie.ai, you'll find a 30-day free trial available there. Thank you, see you next time.